That Noah wasn't no hesitator. And he wasn't no doubter. Because what was in front of Noah, as many of you all are listening, sounds unreasonable. And this is a part of our issue as we exist. That those things that get put in front of us that will cause us to experience the greatness that we were created to be, we never can attain to it because the first thought is, that's unreasonable. But if it were normal, then would it be great? Did you hear that? You have a desire for the greatness because that's how the Lord created you. Understand that. You got a desire for the greatness because that's how he created you. But when you're going to come into it, the greatness, then you have the doubt because you're saying that's unreasonable. But in order to be great, then necessarily then you got to move toward that which is to any regular thinker is unreasonable. Do you understand that? Y'all got that? So when you're coming across something, it don't look like what you used to, then understand you might be coming upon a moment of greatness. You're coming across something that you couldn't fathom. You may be coming upon an opportunity to step into that lane of greatness on this righteous path. And you look around and you're saying, then how do we look around and this wickedness persists in such great numbers? If we had the 7-1 odds. We had the 7-1 odds. How can we look around, man, and all we see is the devastation and the wickedness? These are the questions that are being presented to us as we make it through the scripture. And that's why I'm saying, you had one job. You see now? You see where I'm going with it? You had one job on the 7-1. You know what I'm saying? I know some of y'all watch sports, right? You got a team with a 7-1. And you looking at it, he's like, man, they had one job on Saturday or Sunday, whichever one you watching. Y'all already know I'm still not watching on Sundays. Still. Y'all see me? I'm persistent, man. I'm boycotting. Still. I don't care. All the way through, man. I'm going to stick to what I said. I know some of y'all gave in. Started watching them. And guess what? Y'all lions still got popped. As you hit. Still got popped. You should have just boycotted. Should have just boycotted with me. They still got ran off. Ran out of town. And then they fired the African-American coach. Excuse me. I'm digressing. But listen. You watching this team and you saying they got the 7-1. They only got one job, just go in there and execute. And that's why I entitled this Genesis chapter 7, we had the one job. The stuff is pushed into our favor to be able to execute, man. We got the one job. And yet we look around, we having difficulty with that. We are. We fumbling this ball, man. We having difficulty executing on this one job. What does it look like? Well, I thought about this, man, when I was going through it. And I was like, I never thought like this ever before in my life. And it was harder than what I thought it would be. I thought it would be easy, but then it was harder than what I thought it would be. A lot harder. But when I sunk into it, I got a little afraid first. But when I sunk into it, it reformed me, man. I came out on the other side differently. Just think at the beginning of just one thing. Talk about that one job. Just think of one thing that you can do. Just one that you can do that you believe will be great. But listen, that you're going to do that one thing and it has absolutely nothing to do with your well-being. Pray for you. to be a miracle in my life. The one that has prayed and said, where is Noah coming to help us, to free us from the liberation? That's me. I'm open to see it from one of y'all. But this is what I'm saying, as you step into this game called the keepers of the sheep, you step onto the path and you start to move forward. Like what I'm trying to do. That's what I'm trying. This is the part where I'm going to say I'm going to keep it real with you. When you got that one thing and you holding it close to your heart, man, you like, I'm going to make sure I get that done if anything else. And I'm going to ask you then how many of you, when you get that one thing and you feeling good about it, then how many of you are going to press forward with that one thing when you seeing that one thing, when you make a move toward it, people call it unreasonable. Y'all see where I'm going? That's at the very beginning with Noah. The first thing that's going to happen to you, we see, because Noah's at the beginning of the scripture. Isn't that right? The story of Noah is at the very beginning. The first thing they're going to tell you when you get your greatness in your hand, when you get your salvation in your hand, my brothers, when you get it into your hand and into your heart, you about to move forward in it, the first thing they're going to tell you is, it's unreasonable. That's Noah. You're going to step forward past that, right? I hope you step forward past that, man. I'm praying you step forward past that. But the next thing they're going to tell you, we're going to come to Abraham. They're going to say, man, listen, this right here might cause you to have to leave all your family and friends behind. Y'all heard that? So you still hold tight to your one thing, man? It might be that way for you, like it was for Abraham. You might see, we might experience serious separation because of it. Because he had to walk alone. And he thought that he could bring his nephew with him. But his nephew double-crossed him, really. And he had to walk it alone. And then after Abraham, after they say, then everything that you do with this purpose, with this salvation in your hand, with this one thing in your heart, we're going to call it unreasonable. Now this one, it may cause you to be separated from those that you love. Then the next thing they're going to say, the next thing you may be confronted with when you come across Moses is, what if you have to do it and then you don't get to benefit from it? Because Moses stood on top of the mountain and watched people go in. But did Moses go in? But are you moving forward with it, my brothers? When they say, you got to do it, but you might not benefit. You might not see. No, you might not ever see and live through the greatness that you produce. You still gonna move? Because I'm gonna tell you, man. Then this thing, as you hold it, you might end up being like Joshua and Joseph. And Joseph, man, his brothers threw him in the pit. And then he was enslaved too, man. Holding on to his thing. His one thing, man. You still got it, though? But is you still holding on to it, though? That's what I'm asking you. When you get thrown into the pit and then you put through slavery on account of this one thing, man, you still got it? You still trying to be changed over in a twinkling of an eye, man, or you trying to see death? Which one? Because for sure, like Elijah, man, you might be exiled. And you might be out there in a famine starving. And then the ravens going to bring you food, but you know it's food from a dead carcass. You still holding on to it in exile for several years? You don't know if you're going to survive, man? Do you still got it, though? You still holding on to that one thing, though? This is what I'm trying to tell y'all, man, to keep it real with you, man. Because when you get ready to grab it, then you better grab it, man, but be prepared to hold on to it. You're going to see greatness, man. You're going to move the mark. Oh, you cause whole paradigms to shift, man, but when you hold on to it, man, you might be exiled for several years. Eating meat from dead carcasses, man, that the ravens brought you. So as you holding on to it, then you may be sawed in two, man, like Isaiah. Then you may be beheaded like John the Baptist, man. But then you know that you might be stabbed in the back by your best friend, man. Judas, man, you might be crucified, man. You hold on to it. Are you holding on to it, man, when they crucify you because you won't see death? Then in this moment, you know what greatness is, man. You'll be changed over in the twinkling of an eye. You won't see death.